This is the SAP Developer News for November 21st, 2024.
Hey everybody, it's Josh
and Michelle,
and we are live from Melbourne, Australia, here at the SOGX event, part of the TechEd on Tour. I've had a great time being here, not only taking part in the keynote, we're standing in the developer garage, which you may recognize from other TechEd events. We did this in Florida at ASUG, we're doing it here at SOGX, and I believe there's two more events coming up, right, Michelle?
Yes, we have one in
the UK.
Yeah, and then one in Germany a little bit later next year.
The DataDag event is like in April, I think.
Yeah.
So we're on tour. We're coming out to you guys. We hope that you enjoy meeting with us, the developer advocates, in person. Lots of great things to cover from what was announced at TechEd, as well as lots of great tutorials you can complete for some great little prizes that we have here in the developer garage.
Oh, absolutely. And they've been flying off as soon as people have been finishing so many tutorial tracks to get them all.
All right, so that's it from Australia. We'll see you guys later.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, coming to you live from SOGX in Melbourne, Australia. I wanted to take a quick minute and let you know about the new release of SAP BTP ABAP Environment 2411. And of course, the new blog post from Nora Klemp of ABAP Product Management. Nora gives us all the details about the new features coming in release 2411, including items like you can now use multi-dimensional analysis app generator wizard to create all ABAP development objects that are needed to build, expose, and deploy a multi-dimensional analysis Fiori application. So that's cool, right? We're also getting some enhancements to BRF Plus and the XCO libraries, a ton of enhancements around business events, and much, much more. For more information on the BTP ABAP environment release 2411, check out Nora's blog post today. See you later. I'm going to go jump on a plane. Bye for now, friends.
Just in case you missed it, the October 2024 edition of SAP BTP InnoBytes is out, and it's all out AI and also Terraform. So on the AI front, there's a new SAP Business AI feature catalog on the SAP Discovery Center. And alongside the feature catalog, there's also a feature estimator with which you can work out costs and savings. And there's also a new generative AI-based content generation assistant on the SAP Automation Pilot platform. And for setup of mission-related infrastructure on BTP, you can now use Terraform, which, in contrast to the original booster-based setup mechanisms, allows you to download the Terraform scripts to use. And also, of course, that means you can adopt them and extend them for use in your own landscapes and environments. Open and free. Infrastructure as code. What's not to like? Anyway, find out more about all these new features in this October 2024's edition of the SAP BTP InnoBytes video. Link in the description.
SAP HANA database powers over 70,000 customers worldwide, supporting some of the most critical applications and workloads. With the general availability of SAP HANA 2.0 SPS 08 as of November 20, we at SAP are delivering key updates to enhance scalability, reliability, and developer experience while reducing the total cost of ownership. This release is designed to protect customer investments in our leading multimodal translytical database platform. Starting Friday, November 22nd, tune into SAP Developers channel for our What's New in SAP HANA 2.0 SPS 08 series hosted by Truly Yours Developer Advocates. Over 7 sessions, you'll hear from more than a dozen experts from the SAP HANA product management team. Each session will be packed with insights into the latest features and updates, along with guidance to help you make the most of them. Check out the full schedule in the blog post link below. Don't miss out and join us. The QRC 2024 release of SAP Analytics Cloud went GA this week as well. You can explore the full list of all new features and enhancements in the What's New viewer on the SAP Help portal. The SAP Analytics Cloud team has already released a video showcasing all the significant updates, complete with demos presented by product experts. Discover the highlights of the Q4 2024 release, including bulk migration from classic storage to optimized experience, analytics catalog and grouping assets, story extensibility enhancements, and so much more. Check it out today and start using these new features in your tenant now.
I remember being invited to the first SAP Build Berlin event. It was called something like Burgers Beyond Budgets or something like that. Anyway, it was a great event. I got to talk a little bit. Everybody did hands-ons. And now there's a second event. Not that I was invited to it, but it's still going to be a great event. And it's combined with a Christmas market. So there will be discussions about SAP Build, then a hands-on exercise, which I think I know what it's going to be. And I think so, therefore, it'll be very good. And then you'll go to a different place and you'll have a Christmas market. The only thing I know about the Christmas market is that there will be Glühwein, if I said that correctly. Not that I'm a big fan. The first time I had it was exactly 20 years ago. I was in Heidelberg where it was freezing cold and they gave you Glühwein. And the only good thing about it was that it was hot. Any event, I would go to this event in Berlin. Even if you're far away, I would make your business to come. November 28th, speakers, hands-on, Christmas market. Be a great time. Hope to see you there.
There's a public webinar in early December, open to all and organized by the SAP Open Source Program Office. It's on the Open Search Foundation, how and why it was formed, and why Open Search, an open source enterprise-grade search and observability suite, was moved into that foundation. Plus, lots more from two great speakers. The webinar is on Thursday, the 5th of December. Follow the link in the description to find out more and how to sign up. See you there.